I've been using MSI's Creator Z17 for about a year now as my own personal laptop, but this year's newer model has some nice updates, and I'm thinking it might be time to upgrade. MSI have sponsored this video, so I can show you all about it.
The Z17 has a clean lunar grey finish and a CNC unibody chassis, so it's solid metal, kind of like a Windows version of Apple's MacBook Pro. The metal lid feels solid, and the keyboard deck doesn't flex much when pushing hard. Overall build quality feels good. It wouldn't be a Creator laptop without a great screen, and the Z17 does not disappoint here. The 17-inch 165Hz QHD Plus touchscreen provides accurate colours and gets fairly bright. I really like that it's 16x10, so it's pretty much all viewable screen space without any bottom chin. The screen has stylus support too, with 4096 pressure sensitivity levels, so it'll work well with MSI's Pen 2, and you can bend it right back either for drawing or sharing content with others. My configuration has Intel's Core i9-13950HX processor, NVIDIA's RTX 4070 graphics, and 32GB of RAM. The MSI Center software lets us pick between these different performance modes. Higher modes offer better single and multi-core performance, but with more fan noise. The performance is actually quite impressive compared to other MSI laptops that we've tested so far, only beaten by much thicker models like the Radeon GE68 or Titan GT77. This year's newer model offers a massive 63% boost compared to my older Z17, as I don't think they did the Z17 with an HX chip last year. Performance is still great even if we unplug the charger and run on battery power. Last year's model dipped quite harshly in single core performance, but the newer Z17 scored 111% higher here and just felt snappier to use without the charger. That's an awesome performance improvement considering that both laptops are the same size and are on the thinner side at 19mm or 0.75 inches. The newer one is a little heavier though, which is because it's been upgraded to a vapor chamber cooler, so there's just more material to keep the CPU and GPU cool. MSI says the new vapor chamber provides 76% more cooling area for a 4 degrees Celsius lower surface temperature, but I actually found the difference to be bigger than that. This year's newer model feels noticeably cooler comparatively while also performing better. GPU performance was in line with other RTX 4070 laptops tested, despite the fact that the GPU power limit is actually lower than the others. This is due to NVIDIA's voltage limit, so the 4070 doesn't really go above 90 to 100 watts in most workloads anyway, meaning there's no real downside to using the 4070 in a thinner laptop like this. In any case, it's 40% ahead compared to my older 3070 Ti model. Although it's not a gaming laptop, with these specs, it's absolutely possible to get some gaming done after work. Games look great thanks to the bright, colorful screen. The connectivity options are excellent for creators too, with the Riot having an SD card slot, USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, and HDMI 2.1 output, while the left has the power input at the back, two Thunderbolt 4 Type-C ports, and a 3.5mm audio combo jack. Both Type-C ports provide DisplayPort support, so you can connect an external screen to either, and those as well as HDMI connect directly to the NVIDIA graphics, bypassing Optimus for optimal performance. There's a 1080p camera above the display, and it has IR for Windows Hello Face Unlock.
Here's how the camera and microphones look and sound, and the quality is pretty decent compared to a lot of other laptops I've tested.
There's also a fingerprint scanner just under the arrow keys, which I found accurate and fast. The keyboard and touchpad worked well too, no problems there. The 4 2-watt speakers sound pretty good for a laptop too. They get loud and remain clear with a little bass. Unfortunately, the motherboard is upside down, so upgrades are a bit more involved. We can only access the Wi-Fi 6E card here, but on the other side there are two memory slots and a PCIe Gen 5 M.2 slot, something most other laptops don't offer yet. The speeds from the installed 2TB Gen 4 SSD were quite good, but the SD card slot wasn't able to get the most out of my V90 card. The Z17 is powered by a 4-cell 90-watt-hour battery. Battery life lasted a little under 5 hours while playing a video, and under 2 hours while playing a game. The charger for the i9 model is larger at 280 watts compared to the smaller and lighter 240 watt one that comes with the i7 version, as the higher tier CPU just needs more power. But with 100 watts of Type-C charging, you can get away with a smaller, more portable charger for lighter on-the-go work. Just like all other MSI laptops, even this Creator model has a crazy amount of customization available through the advanced BIOS. It's great to see that this isn't only for the gaming models, as it gives you the option to change pretty much anything you can imagine, from memory timings, thermal limits, power limits, and more. If you're after a laptop for content creation, then MSI's Z17 is worth considering. And I say that as someone that used last year's model for over a year. Before I recently built my new desktop PC with hardware unboxed, I was using the Z17 as my primary system to edit every video on this channel. And now with newer hardware, it's significantly faster at both gaming and content creator workloads. There are plenty of other new MSI laptops this year. Check out this video next to find out about all their other options, or the link below if you're after more information on the Z17.